गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन। दिस इज द सम वी विल डू नाउ इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर स्क्रीन। द पार्टनरशिप डीड, दैट इज द पार्टनरशिप एग्रीमेंट ऑफ ए बी एंड सी ट्रेडिंग इन पार्टनरशिप एज ए बी एंड कंपनी। सो द नेम ऑफ द पार्टनरशिप फर्म इज ए बी एंड कंपनी। And there are three partners A, B, and C. Provides the following information. So interest at 5% on capital accounts. So in the as per the partnership deed, partnership agreement, 5% interest has to be provided on the capital. B and C to be entitled to a salary of ₹500 and ₹350 per month respectively. So B is entitled for a salary of 500 per month and C 350 per month. So when we multiply by 12, you will get the annual salary paid to both B and C. Next, balance of profit to be shared equally. So after paying the interest and salary, remaining profit has to be shared equally among the three partners. Firstly, interest on capital 5% has to be given. Then B, 5 month, 500 per month salary. So into 12, you will get the annual. C, 350 per month into 12, you will get the yearly salary. And then after paying interest and salary, remaining amount is the profit balance of remaining balance of profit from the profit only interest 5% and salary will be paid. Then remaining part of the profit has to be shared equally between the three, equally among the three partners. Now this is a sum of retirement. So here what happens on retirement of a partner, there in this sum, we will be looking into retirement adjustment. So on retirement of a partner, here we'll be giving the effect of retirement in the final accounts. So retirement of a partner, deferred revenue expenses are to be written off in proportion of partner's capital. So what we will have to do, we will have to write off, we'll have to cancel the deferred revenue expenses. Deferred revenue expenses are expenses, but the benefit of the same will be received in future. So we show, and this is a huge amount, so we show the deferred revenue expenses in the asset side of the balance sheet, and this has to be written off. They are saying, इसको कैंसल करो, पार्टनर का रिटायरमेंट हो रहा है तो दिस हैज टू बी कैंसल्ड, रिटर्न ऑफ, बट हाउ? इन द प्रपोजन ऑफ द कैपिटल। सो कैपिटल का वी विल फॉर्म अ रेशियो एंड वी विल डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द डेफर्ड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंसेस अकॉर्डिंगली। नाउ ए रिटायर्स फ्रॉम द पार्टनरशिप एज ऑन 31st December 2013. So there are three partners A, B, and C. From that, A retires from the partnership. So here what happens, A is retiring from the partnership as on 31st December 2013. Partner A is retiring from the partnership business this on what is the date, 31st December 2013, and you are asked to prepare a balance sheet as on 31st December 2013. So we can understand from this information that A, partner A, is going to retire on the last day of the year, because balance sheet also has to be prepared on the same day, and balance sheet is prepared on the year end. So we can make out that A, partner A, is going to retire in the last day of the year, and the same day we will have to prepare balance sheet, final accounts showing the amount payable to A on retirement from the following trial balance. So we will have to find out when A is getting retired, how much amount is payable to Miss Partner A. So when he is retiring, he whatever capital amount is payable to him has to be, yeah, either it has to be paid through cash on the same time. If sufficient cash balance is not there, we will show that amount as A, partner A's loan account. So now he is no longer the partner. So we will say A's loan account. He is getting retired from the business partnership. He is getting retired. So whatever amount is payable to him will be shown as A's loan account. If the business is not able to pay on the spot, it will be carried forward as his loan account. So let us read the trial balance given. Capital account is given. This is the capital A 50,000, B 10,000, C 5,000. A is going to retire. And current account balances is given B 4,000, C 3,000. But the balance of current account is in the debit side of the trial balance. So this is debit balance, trial balance as a debit balance. I mean, current account as a debit balance of B and C. Then we have land and building, which is an asset. Furniture is an asset. Cash in hand is an asset. Liabilities they have given in the credit side, because liabilities have credit balance. As I assume you all know this, that because I have discussed several times when I have started this chapter and even before that, that debit side of trial balance, in the debit side of trial balance, there will be asset and expenses, credit side, liability and income. So liabilities are given in the credit, that will come in the liabilities. And one more thing, trading account ka balance has been directly given. So no need to prepare the trading account. The balance has been given. This is the gross profit. It is having the credit balance, means by gross profit bought down 52,000. No need to prepare the trading account, because the gross profit, trading account profit is already given in the question. So we do not have to prepare the trading account. Trading account balance is already given. Salaries comes in the P&L account. Rent and other expense comes in the P&L account. Depreciation comes in the P&L account. Bad debts also comes in the P&L account. Now stock, when there is no need to prepare trading account, because trading account profit is already given. Can anyone tell me this stock is which stock? Because trading account balance is directly given in the question, which stock this should be? The stock given in the trial balance, when trading account balance is given, so this cannot be opening stock, because trading account mein opening stock aata hai, no need to prepare trading account, because trading account balance is already given, trading account profit. So this stock is the closing stock, that will come in the asset. Debtors also will come in the asset. Cash at bank will also come in the asset. Then here we have deferred revenue expenditure, debit balance, because generally it is shown in the asset side. But because they have told this has to be divided on retirement, this has to be divided among the partners as per the proportion of the capital. When the capital is 50,000, 10,000 and 5,000. We will prepare a ratio out of this capital balance, and accordingly we will distribute 6,500 to A, B and C. So this is the trial balance. Now there is no adjustment with this information and the information of the partnership deed. We will start the solution. We'll start with the solution of the sum. No need to prepare trading account. We will prepare profit and loss account for the year ended. And in the same profit and loss account, we will also prepare the appropriation. No need to prepare a separate account. With P&L account only, we will continue with the appropriation also. Then there is partner's current account, partner's capital account. This is because partner's current account balance is given. Whenever current account balance is given, we prepare partner's current account also, and whatever effect is given to the capital, that effect we give to the current account. That means the capital of the partners is fixed. Whenever partner's current account is given, we keep the partner's capital as fixed. This is known as fixed capital method. Where capital is fixed, whatever adjustment has to be done is done in the partner's current account. And finally, we will prepare the balance sheet of B and C because A is retiring. B and C because A is retiring. So let us start with the posting. First, let us start with the posting. Capital account is there, will come in the capital account balance 50, 10,000, 5,000. Let us go to the partner's capital account. It is in the credit side, means buy, balance, bought down 50,000, 10,000, and 5,000. We have transferred the capital account balance. Because capital balance is in the credit side, it is a liability. Liability has a credit balance. This current account has a debit balance, 4,000, 3,000, B and C. So current account may, what balance will come? Two balance brought down. It is A ka balance, current balance is not there. B ka it is 4,000, C it is 3,000. We have transferred the current account balance also. Now land and building and furniture, there is no depreciation in the adjustment. So directly this will come in the outer column, 37,506,000. So I will go to the balance sheet asset side. And this is how much? This is land and building is 37,500 and furniture is 6,000. Now let us read what else is given. Stock is there, debtor is there, and cash and bank balance. Trial balance means only one effect. Trial balance means only one effect. So, and what is the amount? What is given for stock, debtor, and cash? It is 35,000, 15,000, and 10,000. So let us paste the balances. Now let us go to the credit side. Here there is no debit credit. Everything is given one after another. Correct? There is no, in the trial balance, there is one more way of giving the trial balance where in one place there is debit, in the other there is credit, but this is having both debit credit together. We have to only check the side. So cash in hand is in the debit side. Cash in hand 500. This cash in hand is an asset. So we'll have to show your cash in hand, 500. Cash in hand is 500. Now liabilities, 17,000. Liabilities will come here. Liability side, liabilities. 17,000. Then what we have? Then we have trading account, 52,000. Trading account balance, which in the P&L account, it has a credit balance by gross profit brought down, 52,000. Check, you can see that trading account balance is in the credit side. So in the credit side only we have written, but of the P&L account by gross profit, this is the balance of trading account. I hope you all are able to understand. Now we have some expenses. All the expenses will come in the P&L account. So I will go to the P&L account. In the debit side, expenses are shown in the debit side. Here I will write two salaries to staff, two rent and office expense, two depreciation, two bad debts. So, okay. So we have done this. Now let us see what amount is there. So what we will do, we will again go to the trial balance and we will see the amount. So we'll go to the trial balance. We will see what amount is given, that we will copy here because adjustment is not there. So we have given the effect. Now there is what you say, deferred revenue expenditure. There is a retirement. So they have told here the point says, on retirement of a partner, deferred revenue expenses are to be written off in the proportion of partner's capital. So let us 50,000. What is the capital? 50,000, 10,000 and 5,000. Let us go to the working note. And what is the capital? A, B, C. Capital is 50,000, 10,000, 5,000. Take the ratio out of this. Take the ratio. What ratio we get? Find out the ratio. How many zeros are common? Three zeros are common. So 50, 10 and 5. So what 5 tens are? 5 twos are? 5 ones are? Further, we cannot cancel. 5 ke table mein 50 comes, 5 tens are, 10 comes, twos are, and 5 comes, ones are. So this will be the ratio. Now divide deferred revenue expenditures. Deferred revenue expenditure is 6,500. Divide among A, B, and C. Divide among A, B, and C. A, 6,500 into 10. Divide by 10 plus 2 plus 1 is 30. B, 6,500 into 2 divided by 13. C, 6,500 into 1 divided by 13. Find out what amount we are getting. 5,000. Here we are getting 1,000. And here we are getting 500. Correct? This is the amount we are getting. 5,000, 1,000 and 500. So retirement mein isko cancel karna hai. What all effect we are giving, that we are giving in the current account. So current account mein deferred revenue expenditure debit balance asset hai. And when current account mein se pay karenge, to wo kam ho jayega. So current account waise dekha jaye to normally, see, it is a credit balance. But yahan pe it is given debit balance. Current account is in the debit side and deferred revenue expenditure, it is in the debit only. So debit side mein hum likhenge deferred losses ko hum hamesha cancel karte hai. So it is here losses jab charge hota hai capital partners ko, to it is in the debit side. Revenue expenditure what we have got? 5,000, 1,000, and 500. This also we have done. Ye bhi ho gaya. Now what we will do? What in the partnership deed? What is given? Interest charge karna hai, salary charge karna hai, and profits ko equally divide karna hai baad mein. So what we will do? Let us divide the capital to interest on capital A, B, and C. So how much it is? This capital is 50,000 into full year, 5% interest full year ke liye. So वैसे भी full year means into one ही होगा. 10,000 पे again 5% for full year. If you want, you can write, then it will go 1. या फिर you can write 12 divided by 12, 1 year. It gives the same answer. So I have written directly 5% full year ke liye, because retirement has happened on the last day of the year. Means cap interest full year ke liye milega, salary full year ke liye milega. And 5,000 into 5%. See how much amount you are getting as interest. 50,000 ka 5%, 2,500. 10,000 का 5%, 500, 5,000 का 5%, 250. So total how much we are getting? 3,250. Here what is there? Salary also has to be given, to salary to partners. So only B and C are there for salary. Check the partnership deed. Only B and C are entitled to a salary, 500 per month, 350 per month. So here B ka 500 hai. So 500 into 12 for 12 months. And here 350 into 12 for 12 months. 1 month is 350. So how much for 12 months? We are getting 6,000 and we are getting 4,200. This will become 10,200. Now, what is the next step? Two interest on capital will become by interest on capital. How much is the amount? 2,500, 500, 250. Same way, by salary to salary will become by salary to partner, 6,000, 4,200. And this is done. Now we have to find out remaining. See, they say balance of the profit divided equally. But profit ke liye hame P&L account ko band karna padega. 52,000. Here also 52,000. Now what net profit you are getting? Net profit carried down. How much is the profit we are getting? Minus karo 52,000 mein se 8,000, 7,000, 500, 1,000. How much net profit? 35,500. This will become by net profit brought down. 35,500. So this is credit side is greater. Balance has to be given as profit. So what is the balance which has to be divided among the three? Two net profit carried down. A, B and C. They say after paying interest 5% salary to B and C, balance of the profit to be shared equally. So balance profit kitna hai? Is it 22,050. सो इसको इक्वली डिवाइड करो, 22,050 इनटू थ्री पार्टनर्स आर देयर, सो वन डिवाइड बाई थ्री, इक्वली थ्री पार्टनर्स में 22,050 इनटू वन डिवाइड बाई थ्री, इट विल बी द सेम अमाउंट 22,050 इनटू वन डिवाइड बाई थ्री, डिवाइड करो थ्री से, यू विल गेट द प्रॉफिट अमाउंट 7,350. 7,350. So we have got the profit also. So this has to be divided among the three partners. So by second effect, by net profit, how much it is? 7,350. 7,350 and 7,350. Now we will close this account. How much balance is coming in the current account? 9,850, 13,850 and 11,800. See whether the same amount everyone are getting. All of you are getting the same amount. Now, जो भी बचेगा उसमें पहले तो what we will do, पहले A का close करते हैं. First let us close A because A is going to retire. So that will go to A's capital account. A का जो भी balance आता है that will go to capital account. Transfer. It's a transfer. So current account of A, because A is going to retire. So उसका जो भी balance है वो हम उसके capital account में transfer करेंगे. So how much is it coming? 4,850. A का जो भी balance है, क्योंकि A is going to retire, that we will transfer to A's capital account. And remaining जो है, that we will show in the balance sheet as current account. Remaining B and C partners are not retiring from the business. So उनका जो भी balance है, will be shown as their balance, capital balance. So how much it is coming? 8,850. And here how much it is coming? 8,300. So this will come in the, this is two balance, means ye credit balance, hamesha closing balance is in the opposite side. Agar debit side mein hai to credit balance, credit side mein hai to debit balance. So this will come in the liability side, current account. We can give the, iska opposite effect pehle de dete. 2A will become in the A's account, it will become by A's current account. It will become by A's current account. Current account name of the opposite account to A's capital. In the capital account will become by A's current account. Now how much is the balance? 4,850. And एक और effect इधर कर लेते हैं, current account. कितना करंट अकाउंट बैलेंस वी हैव गॉट बी एंड सी, हाउ मच इट इज? 8,850, 8,300. सो इफ यू वांट वी कैन राइट लाइक दिस, 8,850, 8,300. हाउ मच इज द टोटल? टोटल इज 17,150. करेक्ट. Now, here, what we will do in the capital account, now we have current account is done. Now only capital account is remaining. Close the capital account. Close the capital account. How much we are getting? 54,850. Here we are getting 10,000. Here we are getting 5,000. Close this. Close the capital account. यहाँ पे A जो है retire हो रहा है, ए का जो भी बैलेंस है दैट विल गो टू एस लोन अकाउंट बैलेंसिंग फिगर, ए का जो भी कैपिटल है विल गो टू इस लोन अकाउंट, दिस इज ट्रांसफर और यू में से बैलेंसिंग फिगर और यू में से ट्रांसफर। ए का कैपिटल में जितना भी पैसा है दैट विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू हिस लोन अकाउंट 54,850। ए का अभी इज रिटायरिंग फ्रॉम द बिजनेस सो उसका कैपिटल बोल के वी कैन नॉट कीप, या तो वी कैन पे हिम इमीडिएटली बट वी डू वी हैव सो मच बैलेंस इन कैश एंड बैंक, वी हैव ओनली 10,500 सो हाउ वी कैन पे 54,850 इमीडिएटली। सो दैट अमाउंट विच इज पेबल टू ए वी विल ट्रीट इट एज हिज लोन अकाउंट, दैट इज हिज लोन अकाउंट, ही हैज टू बी रीपेड इन द फ्यूचर, वी विल ट्रांसफर द बैलेंस ऑफ कैपिटल बैलेंस ऑफ ए टू हिज लोन अकाउंट, डन। नाउ लेट अस क्लोज द रिमेनिंग बैलेंस कैपिटल बैलेंस दैट विल बी टू बैलेंस कैरीड डाउन, बीस इज 10,000, बीस इज 10,000 एंड सी इज 5,000, सो जस्ट डू द ट्रांसफर कैपिटल बी बिकॉज नाउ ए इज नो लॉन्गर द पार्टनर, ही हैज रिटायर्ड फ्रॉम द बिजनेस, 10,000 एंड 5,000 दिस विल बिकम 15,000 एंड हियर वी हैव वन मोर थिंग विच हैज टू बी पेड, इट विल बी इन द लाइबिलिटी साइड बिकॉज ये ए को इतना पे करना है दैट इज 54,850। नाउ फाइनली अवर बैलेंस शीट विल टैली हाउ मच इट इज कमिंग, 17,000 प्लस 17,000 हाउ वन मिनट 17,000 प्लस 17,150 प्लस 15,000 प्लस 54,850 हाउ मच इज इट कमिंग, is it coming 1,04,000, check whether you are getting 1,04,000, with this we can say that our balance sheet has tallied, check whether you are getting the same amount 37,500 plus 6,000 plus 35,000 plus 15,000 plus 10,000 plus 500 we should get 1,04,000, with this we can say our balance sheet has tallied and the sum is done. Thank you very much everyone.